Being part of a clan is extremely important in Durango Wildlands. Without one, you will end up spending more resources to get the same things. You will be forced to buy everything outside of your specialization on the island market, and you will have no chance of capturing an outpost, which is the key to some of the best items in the game. So today, Nexon has sponsored me to explain everything you need to know about clans. Joining a clan is really easy. Just click on the clan tab and all of your options come up. After joining the clan, you will be able to access everything you need to know about the clan through these different tabs. As I mentioned in my tips and tricks video for this game, all of the experience that you get personally goes into leveling up the clan. So if you want a powerful clan, you need to be active with active teammates. Donating to your clan allows the clan to build a clan domain. This process is expensive, so everyone needs to pitch in to make it happen, but the rewards are also really nice. The first advantage to having a clan base is that when 10 to 55 people are all building the same base, you guys can make it a much better base than anyone could have built on their own. But even if you're way better than everyone else in your clan, a clan gets access to unique items that you could never build. Meanwhile, you can travel between your clan base and personal base at no cost, so all of these perks come for free. Most clans prefer to split the task of managing the clan base between its members. For example, one member might make all the food, while another member brings food items for that other member, while yet another member is in charge of building a bigger and better kitchen. By specializing in these ways, each player can get really good at what they do best, offering better and better items for the clan, like high-level food that you could never make on your own. As your clan levels up, it will start giving you different perks. These perks include extra experience, decreased sailing and warp costs, a decrease in how many weapons you lose upon death, and a 10% increase in how many T-stones you get. At clan level 6, your clan can build the Censor building. This building allows you to burn incense, which reduces fatigue for all your clanmates in that area. This is an amazing ability, but unfortunately, incense is purchased by warp gems, so if your entire clan is free to play, then it might not be worth building it. At level 7, your clan can build the Defense Tower. The Defense Tower can be placed near courier warp holes on Savage Islands, and they are exponentially more effective the more of them that you built. That being said, if you're only a clan level 7, you probably don't need to be worrying about defense towers yet, because they don't really become important until you're fighting for resources on Savage Islands. At level 9, your clan can build clan storage. A clan can build as many of these storage units as they want, and each of them have thousands of storage slots. It is important for these units to stay organized, so make sure to pay attention to how your clan designates these tabs. And it is also important for clan chieftains to not give access to these units to play players that cannot be trusted. At level 10, your clan can build the Warp Hole Tuner. This is a very advanced building that your clan will not need until Clan Wars, but to sum up its purpose, Warp Hole Tuners block an enemy's attempt to capturing your clan's outpost. They are really expensive to build, and there are a ton of different ways that they can lose their effectiveness, so you really don't want to worry about building one of these until you are vying for a top position in a clan war. At level 11, your clan can build the Collection Research Center. Research centers allow your clan to give even stronger buffs than the ones come automatically. The Collection Research Center specifically allows you to increase your ability in collecting plants, minerals, and animal parts. If you're below level 40, this might not seem like that big of a deal, but as you get higher level, your chance of failing to get a certain resource because of the lack of the ability becomes a lot more common. It's still not that big of a deal, but the higher level you get, the more nice it is having it. At level 12, your clan can build the Exploration Research Center. This research center specializes in helping you with your interactions with stealth and with taming animals. For more information about stealth and everything you need to know about pets, make sure to check out my video on that subject. At level 13, your clan can build the Combat Research Center. This research center gives very strong buffs in combat, like more max health, self-healing, and large bonuses to attack and accuracy, and defense and dodging. These are essential for a clan that wants to reach the top on the Savage Islands. At level 14, your clan can build the Catapult. The Catapult looks amazing, and it seems like it would be effective on a Savage Island, but I can't tell you exactly how good it is because even my high level friends have yet to see it in action. At level 15, your clan can build the Crafting Research Center. The Crafting Research Center allows you to get large ability point buffs for every type of crafting in the game, which again might not seem like that big of a deal, but if you are trying to craft the best items in the game, then getting a failed attempt will waste a lot of your time and resources. And then, unlike combat and gathering, increasing your crafting ability also allows allows you to unlock new blueprints that are otherwise unattainable. At level 16, your clan can build the Advanced Research Center. At the time I'm making this video, almost all of the main clans had not yet reached level 16, so I was not able to get you guys pictures, but the Advanced Research Center allows you to research the ability to tame special pets like the wolf, Smilodon, Ankylosaurus, Uptoraptor, and the Gallimimus. And then at level 17, your clan can build the Town Hall. The Clan Hall is a very beautiful building, which is good because that's its only purpose. I'd still recommend building it because you were able to get your clan to level 17, which is impressive, but other than that, it has no purpose. After that, clan levels 18 through 25 just increase your domain, alliance, and clan member numbers. As your clan levels up and you get stronger members, one of the biggest advantages you have in working together is capturing an outpost on a savage island. Savage islands have some of the best loot in the game, including unique items like oak barrels and Dutch coffee makers, but they are PvP islands, so going by yourself is often futile. Furthermore, when you are on a savage island, you cannot warp back to your base with items from that island. Rather, you are required to use warp couriers to get items off the island, which is why having a well-defended clan outpost is so effective. Well, that's it guys, hope that helps. I again got a lot of my information from the Discord admin Caffeine, who helps run the largest Durango Discord server and is a member of the Nos clan. But I also got some great information from Metanova and Frost, who are both from the Dynamos clan. So I have links to that Discord and to Frost's YouTube channel in the pin post of this video. Also, this video was sponsored by Nexon. If you liked it, please thank Nexon for hiring me to do it. This game is incredible, and I would love to continue to grow that relationship. All right, guys, I'll see you next time.